Welcome. In this video, we're going to work with Dataproc. So we have to scroll down. As you can see, there are two labs over here, Dataproc, Quick Start Console, and Command Line. On the previous video for data flow, I went from with tablets, but with the command line interface. So for Dataproc, I will use the console of Google Cloud. So open it. And as you can see, it will take us no more than 30 minutes. It's an introductory. We will pay only one credit. Cloud Dataproc is a fast, easy to use, fully managed cloud service for running Apache Spark and Apache Hadoop clusters in a simple, more cost-effective, efficient way. Operations that used to take hours or days take seconds or minutes instead. And believe me, it's true. Create Cloud Dataproc clusters quickly and resize them at any time, so you don't have to worry about your data pipelines outgrowing your clusters. This lab will show you how to use the Google Cloud console to create a Google Cloud Dataproc cluster, run a simple Apache Spark job in the cluster, and then modify the numbers of workers in the cluster. Over here it says again that we have to click on the Start Lab button, and when we click it, the time will start counting down, and we cannot pause it, so we have to finish it everything in 30 minutes. And in order to work, we will use the credentials that we are going to be provided. So let's click on the Start Lab. I'm not a robot. Okay, I'm going to use my subscription. Here are the credentials. I'm copying the username and right click over here to open it on incognito. And I'm using my student account, so I need the password of the student over here. Copy it and paste it and then click next. I'm accepting everything. Yes, I confirm. And I'm waiting for my Google Cloud platform for this project. Yes, I agree with the terms. And now I'm ready to start. I'm checking the project ID over here. It's the same with this one. And yes, I'm working on my Google Cloud account as a student. It's always crucial to check here if you are working with your student account or your normal account, and please avoid it. That's why I'm working with incognito. Every time I close it, I don't have problems. And over here, it's the project ID that it is created for me and not my project that I already have over here. So let's scroll down. Everything is what we have done. First thing first, we need to check if we have the credentials to work. So let's go to IAM over here, and we need to see. And yes, we are the editor and the compute agent that we are going to work over here. So if you don't have the credentials, then you have to click on add, and the new member, select the role from here, and then from here you have to go to project, over here project, and from here to the editor, and then click save. But for me, everything is fine, so I don't have to do anything else. Now I have to confirm that the Cloud Dataproc API is enabled. To do that, I'm going to navigation menu, click on that, and then go to API services, and then to library. Over here I'm going to type Cloud Dataproc, and it's searching. This one, nope. I need Cloud Dataproc API. It's over here, this one. Click on it. And it is enabled, as you can see. So there are some cases that it's not enabled, so we have to click enable. Okay. Now we are going to create a cluster. We're going to navigation menu. We're going to scroll down to find Dataproc. It's over here. And we go to clusters. We want to create a cluster. And we'll use as a name example cluster. As a region, we're going to write global. Here, global, and as a zone we need the US central one A, US central one A. So the cluster is being created. Check my progress. Everything is fine. So now we go to jobs. We need to wait a little bit. And then submit a job. And as a cluster, we have example cluster for a job type, Spark. Main class, we need to copy it from here. For arguments, jar file, this one, and we can always open it and check if everything is correct as it's shown here. Spark example global job ID. Okay, it's a job ID, everything is fine, and then we can submit it, and we are submitting the job. Here you can read how it is calculated, and our job is going to appear in the job list over here. Let's hide this for now, and as you can see, it is running. Example cluster, it's a type Spark and global region. When it will finish, we're going to have status of succeeded. So let's check our progress, and the status is already succeeded. As you can see, we are 80 out of 100. Now we want to view the job output. So we have to click this ID over here. And this is the line wrapping. We can scroll everything to read it, to check it. To change the number of workers in instances of our cluster, we need to select our clusters. So let's go a little back. And click on the clusters. As you can see, we have two workers over here running. Let's open it. We need to check the configuration over here, and we need to edit it. So the worker nodes were 2. So now let's say we want 4 and then save it. It's so easy to change it. My clusters are updating over now, as you can see. Let's go to VM instances. They are here, 1, 2, 3, 4 workers. We can check our progress. It's a green. We have finished it. This one is already finished for us successfully. To return the job with the updated cluster, we have to click on jobs and then click submit a job. Great. The cluster is example cluster, not Hadoop, it's a Spark. Again, we need to specify this one. The argument is 1000, the jar file that we need. And then we submit it. We have one which was succeed, and if we open it, this was the jobs that already have done, and then go back for the jobs. The second one also is finished, and everything is fine, everything is ready. 100%, everything is fine. As I've already told you, this is a student project. So I can just click here, the X button. But if it is a real project, you have to close everything, delete everything, not to get charged. So now let's press the X over here and maximize it. We have finished everything. I'm not gonna help you with the test your understanding. You have to answer them by yourself. Don't worry. This lab has finished successfully. You have got your 100 points over here. So in case you answer something wrong, you have the opportunity to learn, retry again, and do it correct. So this time we have worked with Dataproc. So if you type cloud.google.com/dataproc, you go to this documentation page about Dataproc, and you can read more about this tool, about this technology, the customers that uses Dataproc, documentation, use cases you can find over here, features, everything that you need, the pricing, everything that you need about Dataproc is over here. Great. Next steps. After finishing each lab, it's a good tip always to go and read the documentation of the tool of the technology you have already used on Qwik Labs. If you want to learn how to use Google Cloud Platform, how to work with Google Cloud Platform, how to prepare yourself for the Google Cloud certification, it's a good tip always after the lab to go and read the documentation. It will help you a lot, believe me. So, thank you for watching this video. See you on the next one.